From Major General Mohammed Ali Shah, sir, how essential do you think is this forward planning at this point of time, especially when we're talking about China and India tensions that have been ongoing? Even though we have reached to a point of disengagement, how essential do you think is this forward planning at this point?
It is very, very important. See, we have already. As General Subedar correctly pointed out just now, that India is fully prepared. We have all the arrangements made over there, including not just weapons and equipment, but as per the strategic planning as well, the contingency planning as well. If then else, if this plan doesn't work, then that plan, plan A, plan B, we have everything in place. So India does not lack from anywhere. Apart from that, we are also getting aid, foreign aid. We are getting support. You know, in our time, when I was serving, I'm talking about way back in 2003, when we had 5.5mm missile rifles, or AK-47s, or 7.62 light machine guns, we had the equipment we had. Only the special forces had upgraded weapons. Now we have different, now we have 6 or 7.6 assault rifles, we have the Swiss MP9, the pistols, now the fast erectable modular shelter. The FEMS, which can take a week and can host at least 40 troops inside. So that can, we have all the equipment, as General Subedar rightly said, we have the artillery guns in place, even in such tough locations where the movement is restricted, but we have penetrated, we have gone the maximum that we could actually go. That area is very tough. That's why it could not be fenced. That's why it's called the line of actual control. It's a perception. The entire 3,488 km stretch is a perception, unlike in the park water where it's line of control. So we are fully prepared, and this forward planning always takes us a step or two forward. Because China's strategy is what? They will pull back one step and then slyly and quietly, when no one's looking, try to move forward two steps. So it's null and void. It's as much taking one step forward but in the slide. India does not do that. India is very clear. It's principally, I'll give you a small example, a very small example. You know, I'm relating it to something which an incident of last evening when India won an Olympic gold. The whole world saw it when our Subedar Chopra Sahab, he folded the national flag in a very respectable manner and took it along with him. Unlike other sportsmen who have thrown it in the chair of other countries. This shows the ethos of the Indian Army. How much we actually respect the Indian flag, the tricolor, for which we actually give our lives for. We put a line at stake. Now, when we are delivering that tricolor, I've given you a very good example, a very good parallel that I've equated it with a very, very recent and a very apt example. So, our forward planning only takes us not one step but two steps forward.
Right. Thank you, sir. Now, since we are running short of time, we'll leave it at that.